I love talking about purpose. How can you get tired of talking about purpose? Mm-hmm. And this is a tool made for this, to discover your purpose. I'd love to know. Tell us about the message and how you came to write it.
Well, for me, I have been blessed to have some people process with me, like, what are your gifts? What does it look like to look at the story of your life and where God's taken you, and to see intention, that God is a God of intention. He has plans, and he is good and kind to not set his plan for us, you know, far, far out there where we can't find it, where it's impossible to know. He actually, I believe, weaves it into what I talk about in the book, are the threads of our lives, that those threads are visible to us. We can see them. In fact, they probably don't feel special to you. They feel like something that, you know, it's just, oh, I remember one of my friends, she laid all her threads out and she was like, I mean, this isn't anything special. And I think that's so common for especially women. Maybe it's with men too.
Yeah, I think it is.
That they can't see that they've been uniquely gifted and set in their places. Acts 17 says that God sets us in our allotted time period and he draws our boundary lines. Mm-hmm. And it's so that perhaps people can feel their way to him. So I do think we were built for this and we were made for this. And yet it scares us sometimes. It feels intimidating.
At the end of that 40 days, does the reader come away?
Magical. Just like she's magic.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. Check.
No, what happens at the end of the 40 days?
What I've seen happen in people is that they discover things about themselves. And maybe they were things that they already knew, but they didn't realize were important or noteworthy, or that God had put those things in their lives.
Right.
And sometimes it's recognizing, you know what? I know exactly what God's called me to do. I'm just not doing it because I've been afraid.
Right.
So sometimes it's seeing things and realizing that there's these barriers to living out what God's called us to do, because we all have that. We get stuck. You know, we get in this place where we don't know why we're not making movement or why we're not stepping out, but there are reasons.
Right.
And which, you know, counselor, there's some deep stuff in there.